بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم به نستعين صلى الله وسلم على نبينا الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Respect elders and brothers, mothers and sisters. I hope you guys are all doing well, safe, with your health and your iman. We ask Allah عز وجل to safeguard us, our family during this difficult times and in this pandemic and in this crisis. And those of us who have passed away, may Allah عز وجل forgive them and give them Jannat al-Firdaws al-A'la. Inshallah, today we will make an attempt to do the tafsir of Surah Al-Mutaffifin. It is the 83rd Surah of the Quran and the sequence of the Mus'haf. It's the 83rd, it has 36 verses. The reason why I wanted to talk about this Surah today is because in the beginning of this Surah, Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about those people who are buying and selling, and they're very stingy, or they don't give people the full amount when they're selling or when they're buying. And I feel like things like that are happening now, especially because of the lack of supplies when it comes to especially medical supplies like masks and, you know, hand sanitizers, etc. So we definitely do see that nowadays when you go outside to even the supermarkets. You know, before they weren't so busy, and now they're so busy. And the way the workers treat you is like, you know, you take it or you don't. Just get, you know, the behavior is not the same anymore. Whenever you go to a place where the demand is high, they lose respect for the customers. So, in that regards, I just wanted to talk about Surah Al-Mutaffifin today, because in the beginning of the Surah, this is what it's about, sellers and consumers. So, as for when this Surah was revealed, some scholars say it was revealed in the Meccan period. Some say it was revealed in the Medinan period. So why are differences? You know, some scholars have said that when a surah is revealed in a certain time or a certain occasion, shuyukh like Shahuniullah Dahlawi, he has said that whenever you see that a surah was revealed after this incident or before this incident, it doesn't necessarily mean that just when this happened, this verse revealed, but rather that we know this verse existed, this thing happened, and we feel like it was because of this reason, or this was the effect, or this is one of the places where we can apply it to. So that's why some have said this was revealed in Makkah. Ibn Abbas said it was the last surah in Makkah, and then some say it was the first surah in Medina. He also contradicts himself, and he says some of it was in Makkah and some of it was in Medina. Some have said that this was a Madani surah, because when they went to Medina, the people of Medina that were there from before, كانوا من أخبث الناس كيلاً, they were the most abhorrent of people in terms of weighing and measuring. So that's why it was in Medina. But in Medina, people were actually doing farming. So this most likely it was in Makkah, because this Makkah was a hub of business, a center for business. So most likely it was in Makkah. So وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ. وَيْل, it has different variation. وَيْح with the ha in the end, وَيْك with the kaf in the end, وَيْل with the lam in the end. All of these mean woe or destruction or great loss, or how terrible, or hell with this person. It's almost like a curse. This was the language of the Quraysh at the time. وَيْل, right? Some would say وَيْلِي, يَا وَيْلِي, woe to me, I have done something awful. وَيْلَك, woe to you. So وَيْلٌ, woe to those who are مُطَفِّفِينَ. And we're going to talk about who those مُطَفِّفِين are. But in simple language, it means those who give less than do. We'll talk about it more. But وَيْلٌ, it means woe. Okay. Ibn Abbas has said that وَيْل is actually a valley in Jahannam. It's a name of a valley in Jahannam. So whatever it might be, the primary meaning we understand is that yes, for loss and how terrible, and you know, these people are wicked. Who are these people? Mutaffifin, those who give people less than what is due. So tufaf, tafafa yutaffifu, actually means like the, you know, if you're pouring a cup of water with water, and then when you stop, but you stop too late and some water spilled out, that's like tufaf. Similarly, if you are if you go and buy a pizza and if there's like grains on top of the slice, those things are called tifaf. So mutaffif is the person who either gives too much, like those sprinkles, gives a little bit of sprinkles, Or they take some of that sprinkle. What it actually means is like when sellers, when they used to sell, let's say, a cup of rice, they used to have this flat metal that they used to scrape the top off. But if that metal had a denting in it, then when they're scraping off, they're actually going to also take some off what is due to the customer. So that's mutaffifin, those people who take the share of what they're supposed to give to others, selling to others. All right, so that's what mutaffifin are, right? And nowadays, you know, we don't really have that, but if sometimes you go to a grocery and like you're buying, let's say, 40 items, you're not really checking how much the guy is, you know, putting in the machine. You know, if something is 450, you know, you could just quickly put 550 and you're not going to realize that. So it's just a little bit of something that they're taking. But if they do it to 100 people, that's like that's $100 without, you know, people even knowing. So those are those mutaffifin. So Allah is saying, wail to them, woe be to them, because these people exercise bad business practices. All right. So alladhina, who are they? They not only when they are selling they do this, but alladhina idha ktalu ala an-nas yastawfun, when they are buying from people and they are let's say, you know, back in the day was scales, so I'm buying 1 pound of rice, they're going to make sure that they get that 1 pound of rice, nothing less. So yastawfun, they get it completely, they want all of it, you know. Or like if they go to a pizza store and they buy pizza and like the pizza is cold or too much cheese, you know, they get mad, like, I don't want this, give me another one. Or you go to Starbucks and like the sugar is too little, or, you know, something is off a little bit, you get mad and you get pissed off and you're like, I don't want this, give me another one, or give me something else for free, you know. So that's like you trying to get all of your rice, trying to get, you know, every penny that you paid for. Okay, it's like haggling for price. You know, in America, you can't really do that. When you go to like Macy's, something says $49.99, you gotta pay $49.99. But then if you go to like Umrah and Hajj, and those miskin people on the road, they're selling cheap stuff, you know, 5 riyal, 5 riyal. You start haggling and you know, try to negotiate with those poor guys for like 1 or 2 riyals. Like, it's not really gonna amount to much in the US dollars. But why? You know, you want to support those guys, actually give them extra. If they're 5, give them 10, like, you know, you can keep the rest. You can do that, right? But instead, we're like trying to haggle and negotiate with those guys. You know, you're going from America, you probably are, you know, well, financial state. You know, you don't have to do that when you go there. And like, you know, I've walked with people, and they're well off, mashallah. But then, like, when you go over there and we're like going with them shopping, you know, it's like sometimes embarrassing. So whatever, it's fine, you know. If you want to do that, it's fine. But the problem is, وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ, when they are on the selling end, and when they are the sellers and the businessmen, what do they do? وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ, when they measure them, when they measure the volume of something, like commodity, rice, or like milk, liquid, أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ, or they weigh them. Usually currency, you got to weigh the currency and see how much that silver or gold coin holds in value. So when they measure other people, then so the letters in the Arabic over here is supposed to be is وَإِذَا كَالُوا لَهُمْ, when they measure for people, and lam is for istiqab, is for deserving something. These people deserve that, but the lam is not even there. It's like you don't give them what they deserve. Well, the other meaning is when they actually measure the people, measure up the people. What does that mean? It's like, you know, you have a customer, especially in like car businesses and stuff, or like car dealers or like mechanics. And some guy comes and he doesn't know about cars. And he says, you know, my car is making this noise. And so you look at this guy, like this guy probably has, the way he's talking, he has no idea what about cars. So you're like, you just tell him, oh, you got to change the oil. You got to change, you know, a lot more other things. Like, I have no idea about cars. A lot more other things than what actually the problem is. Or like, you know, if you're trying to go in a long trip, a road trip with your family, and you see that your screen on the car says that check tire pressure. Now you put the air and everything, but it keeps coming back. So you're scared. You don't know what all this stuff is about. So you go to the tire shop and you're like, you know, this tire is giving me this problem and I'm trying to go on a long road trip with my family. So the guy, this guy has no idea about tire pressure, and you just got to do something, make a little tweak, and it'll be okay. But so he's like, you know what? You gotta change all four tires, and it looks like they're all wearing off, and it's gonna be dangerous. You shouldn't drive all that long with these tires, you know? So when they, based on the people, right? You see what kind of people they are, and then you give them a price, which is wrong. So when they measure other people or they're trying to sell to other people, يخسرون, they cause loss to those people. They fraud them. Or يخسرون, it doesn't just say they cause loss to the consumers. It just says يخسرون, they cause loss. It means either the consumers, or it means they cause loss in society at large. They cause loss. Meaning when you start doing that, other people, when they're in this business, when they're trying to start this business, you know, in the beginning, they're going to struggle. And if they come to you for advice, you're going to tell them, listen, man, this is the game, and you got to start doing the same thing. And they're like, you know what, man, you're right. I got to start doing the same thing. You know, when you're in Rome, you got to act like the Romans. Brother, if you want to be in the game, you got to do this. This is how it is, and you got to do it. You know, they cause loss to the consumers and at society. They cause loss to society at large. Okay? Now, why do people fraud? And why do charge extra or give less? Right? So in the Quran, there are three fundamental messages in the Quran. Tawheed, yani believing in Allah, Risala, believing in the message of the Prophet ﷺ, and Al-Ba'th, believing in Qiyamah, in the Day of Judgment. So when any person has a khalal, a shortcoming in any of these three, you will see that manifest in their actions. So Allah is saying, أَلَا يَظُنُّ لَكَ أَنَّ مَبْعُثُونَ. Do they not think, do they not believe that they're going to be resurrected? Then Allah is questioning their belief in the resurrection. They think that they're not going to be raised again. Why are they doing this? Don't they think that they'll be caught? They think they're just going to get away? They think there'll be no trial for them held? لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ, for a great day where they'll be held in trial in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla. The day when يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, when all people, the entire mankind, will stand up لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, for the Lord of the universe. Right? And then Allah says, so after you're in a trial and a judgment is made, usually a person is convicted and then sentenced to a certain amount of years in the prison. So Allah says, كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْفُجَّارِ لَفِي سِجِّينَ. No, never. The Kitab, the scribe, the record of deeds of the Fujjar, of the sinners. Right here, where the Fujjar is actually the Mutaffifin, those guys used to fraud and take people's share. Here, Allah is not Kitab al-Mutaffifin, he's saying Kitab al-Fujjar. And they used to think that they're just taking a little bit Mutaffifin, they're just taking little rights of people. But Allah is saying, no, you don't, you think you're just Mutaffif, you're actually a Fujjar, a Fajr, someone who's a great sinner. In Fajr, I mean, so like explode and blow up. And Fajr is called Fajr because the light bursts out of darkness. So people who leave their lane, leave their boundaries, Fujjar, great sinners, they will be in their book of records will be in Sijjin. Sijjin is a regular prison. But Sijjin, Fi'il, it means like a grand prison, an inescapable prison that you can't escape from. So their book of deeds will be over there. That's a hint that they will be over there. If you're not going to be there, what's your book doing over there, right? So that's kind of like not to give shock to this person. You're just hinting that you just got to go there. If someone right now, the cops came to, took your ID, for example, and told you, go pick it up from Rikers Island. Wait, what? Why I got to pick it up from Rikers Island? You know, you realize like maybe that's where I'm headed. So in Kitab al-Fujjar la fi Sijjin, the book of the Fujjar is going to be in the Sijjin. Now, as woman, what idea do you have about Sijjin? This terrible, this grand, inescapable prison. What idea you have about it? You have no idea what it is, right? It's like your parents, when you have an exam coming and they don't see you studying for it. They're like, do you even know what this exam means? What this, you know, specialized high school test means? Or this ASAT? Do you even know what that means for the rest of your education and career? Right? So like, Allah is saying, do you have any idea about how terrible that Sijjin is? You don't. You don't even want to get into it. Kitabun Marqum, their destination of getting there is written in a book. Not just written with ink, because when you write with ink, there is a possibility that it can wipe away and fade away. Marqum, raqam, literally means something that stands out a little bit. So for example, if I wrote something on my shirt with ink, that's not standing out. But if I stitch something on my clothes, that's, you know, standing out. You can feel it. And it's like Braille's for blind people. You know, you can feel it, it's protruding, it's standing out. So when you write something with ink, there's a possibility it might wash away. But when you stitch something to something, that's not washing away, that's gonna stay there. So these people, their destination, it's written that they're gonna be there, stitched with embroidery. There's no, not, it won't be changed at all. And the last thing, وَيْلُ يَوْمَ يَذِلِّ الْمُكَذِّبِينَ. Woe be to those people who deny others. مُكَذِّب. Kadhib is someone who lies. Mukadhib is someone who calls other people liars. So let's say this guy is mutaffif, who takes other people's rights. He cheated someone, and the person came in and said, look, you did this. And you know that you cheated that person, you're selling him liar. No, you're not doing this, right? Can you imagine a person like that? So mukadhibin, those who deny. Deny what? Alladhina yukadhibuna biyawmiddin. If these people can deny the truth right in front of its face, then it's not far-fetched for them to deny the Yawmuddin, the Day of Judgment. So alladhina yukadhibuna biyawmiddin, those who deny the Day of Judgment. وَمَا يُكَذِّبُ بِهِ إِلَّا كُلُّ مُعْتَدٍ أَثِيمٍ. And who denies the Day of Judgment? Not everybody's going to deny, have the audacity and have the ungratefulness in their heart to deny. It's only those people who are mu'tad, who are sinful, athim, always sinning, always sinning. Athim is someone who is sinning, but athim is someone who's always sinning. So this mutaffif guy, you know, he's always sinning, you know, taking from people all the time and doing this wrong all the time. And then from that money, he's, you know, building other things and building onto his business. And the new things in the product and commodities he buys, he's buying from that money which he got from the fraud. So he's just in a cycle of just continuously just doing one after another. And when that happens, when people are in that state and they're constantly sinning, then role reminders will work on them. So when the إِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا, when our verses are recited to them, they say what? They say أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. This is just a story of the former people. What is this? You know, this is not even updated. We need something. We need a new version. Right? أَسَاطِر actually comes from the Greek word أُسْطُورَ. And story actually comes from the same word. So asalt is like anecdotes and stories of the former people. I get it out my face, right? What is this? You criticize and you're saying it's not even, you can't even implement the Quran. Basically, you know, when people say these days, like, oh, this is, that was for back days. Nowadays, we can't really practice upon that. Asalt al-awwalin, that's what they say. Allah saying, no, kalla, no. Bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. The thing that they used to earn, the extra money or the fraud or the things that they should do, it has covered up their hearts. It has covered up their hearts. The Prophet ﷺ was asked about, what is this on? What is this this black spots or dark spots in the person's heart? So the Prophet ﷺ said, in the labday the adhanaba dhanban, when a person, when a slave, he commits a sin, kanat nuktatun sawda, there's a dark and a black dot in his heart, fi qalbi. فَإِن تَابَ مِنْهَا, if he does tawbah from it, سُقِلَ قَلْبُ, his heart is polished clean. وَإِن زَادَ, but if he continues doing and he increases in his sinning, زَادَت, and that wrong, that impurity will also increase. فَذَلِكَ قَوْلُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, that is the word of Allah, كَلَّا بَلْرَانَ عَلَى قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. They don't feel guilt anymore, no shame, nothing, because of that wrong that's in their heart. كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. Indeed, rather, they will be barricaded from their Lord. Mahjub comes from hijab. They will be veiled. They will not see their Lord on that day. They will be barred to see their Lord, the faces of their Lord. Right? But what will they see? They will, ثُمَّ إِنَّهُمْ لَصَالُ الْجَحِيمِ. They will enter. They will be admitted into the al-jahim, which is Jahannam. ثم يقال, then it will be said to them, هذا الذي كنتم بتكذبون, this is the thing that you used to deny, this is what you used to say, now this is not gonna happen, right? This is what it is, now you see it. And it will be ذق, and it will be said to them, taste this, إنك أنت العزيز الكريم. And so this is the end of these people who try to fraud or take too much of what is due to them, right? So notice how here Allah doesn't bring anything about a person's iman or kufr. This is a universal law, Right? Justice has to be practiced all across the spectrum, whether believers or non-believers. You know, it's for all. Just because someone is a non-believer doesn't mean that you can fraud them. Right? So it's for everyone. So now we're talking about the opposite type, the abrar. Right? كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْأَبْرَارِ لَفِي عِلِّيِّينَ. Now we talk about the book of deeds of the abrar, the pious people, will be in the عِلِّيِّين, the righteous who are in عِلِّيِّين. عَلَى يَعْلُو عُلُو means to be high. عِلِّيِّين, those people who are in high status. يعني their book of deeds will be with the angels. So if your book of deeds with the angels is in a high place, high status, where are you going to be? You're going to follow your book and you're going to end up there as well. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا عِلِّيُّونَ. And what do you think about the عِلِّيُّون, those highly high status people? كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ. There, it will be, it's a book that is inscribed, that is already, that is going to be with those who are in a high status. يَشْهَدُ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. It will be witnessed by the مُقَرَّبُونَ, those who are held close to Allah Azza wa Jalla, brought close to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and the righteous and the angels. If a person is righteous in this world, right now his book of deed could be with the muqarrabun, those who are close to Allah Azza wa Jalla. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ. Indeed, the abrar, the pious people, the righteous people, they'll be in na'im, in pleasures. عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ. They will be upon araik. They will be upon cushions and sofas and nice pillows. Just looking, yanzurun, just looking at all the beautiful things that are in front of them, taking pleasure from that. تَعْرِفُ فِي وُجُوهِمْ نَظْرَةَ النَّعِيمِ. You will see in their face radiance of pleasure. You will see radiance in their face. It's like when, you know, if you ever travel to Bangladesh or back home, wherever your country is, with your parents, and if you ever look at their face when they're about to land in the country, right? Their face lights up. It's like they've been missing their homeland for so long. That's like nadra, you know? نَظْرَةَ النَّعِيمِ. يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيقٍ مَخْتُومٍ. Over there, they will be given, they will be served drinks from the rahiq makhtum, from the pure wine which is sealed. Pure wine which is sealed. So over there, no, you don't have to go and grab it. There's no self-service over there. You're going to be served, right? From the rahiq, which is wine, but it has no intoxication. Wine of this dunya and the akhirah is different. It will have the same name, but the content of that wine is different than the wine of this world. First of all, the wine of this world intoxicates. Wine of the hereafter is not going to intoxicate you. Why do people even get intoxicated? Because they want to get away from their problems. Now in Jannah, you're not going to have any problems. So why you have to, you know, run away from? Run away from what, right? And it's sealed, right? You know, even nowadays, wine, they seal it and it's corked up. And the older the wine bottle is, the more expensive it is. It's just how it is, right? It takes a long time. The older the wine is, the better it is. So these things are already makhtum, they're already sealed. So when you get there, it's been sealed for so long, right? Khitamuhu misk. Its seal, the cork, will smell like musk. It's a very elegant and high quality perfume, misk. Some say it comes from the belly of deer. I don't know how authentic that is. But it's just the cork will have that smell. Before you even open it, you smell the cork and oh my God, you're going to be out of this world just by smelling it. So Allah says, وَفِي ذَلِكَ. And in that, فَلْيَتَنَافِسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. Let those who want to compete, let them compete in that. Meaning just to reach that moment. That's enough for you. It's not just any type of competition, right? Nafis, it comes from the word nafis. Nafis is something very precious. And it's like the Olympics. So there's a grand prize to it. Okay. And the mixture of that drink. So now you open it and you taste it. And you'll see that it is mixed from tasneem. And we'll talk about what tasneem is. Mizaj actually is like a cocktail. Mixture of different drinks. So mizaj, it will be from tasneem. And tasneem is actually a drink, a fountain, a waterfall that's in the highest place of Jannah. And the reason why highest place comes is because tasneem, the original radical letters here are seen, noon, meem. And sanam is like the hump of a camel, the highest part of a camel. So the highest place in Jannah, that's where there will be a waterfall, a spring. From that, some material, some of the drinks, the drink will be mixed with some of that. And some of us don't have said, depending on your actions, how well and how good your deeds are, that's how much amount of tasneem you will get in your drink. So what is that? Aynan, it is a spring. Yashrabu biha al-muqarrabun, those who are close to Allah, they will drink from that. Okay? So that was an episode of the Abrar. Now going back to the disbelievers, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا, those who were criminals, who committed sins, كَانُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يُضْحَكُونَ, they used to laugh and jest and joke regarding those who bought iman. Those who had iman, they used to laugh at them. You know, someone wearing hijab pass by, they stare at you. Maybe they won't laugh directly or say something, but وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِهِمْ, when they pass by them, يَتَغَامَزُونَ, they wink at each other. That's what ghamaz mean, to wink and like jest and like push someone with the elbow, like, yo, look at that, and like just laugh around, right? وَإِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمْ انْقَلَبُوا فَكِهِينَ, and when they go back to their family, they go back فَكِهِينَ, comes from فَكِهَ, something tasty, right? It's like they can taste the insult they gave to those people, the laughing and joking, jesting when they go back to their family. It's like it's not done, but when they go back home, they'll tell their family too, like, you see these people, there's Muslims and whatever else it might be, right? So they try to create a generation after them who's also going to carry on this hate and this despise for those who believe. وَإِذَا رَأَوْهُمْ قَالُوا إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَضَالُّونَ, and when they see them, they say, these guys are lost. They're immigrants, no immigration status, no social status, no financial status. Guys are a lost cause, you know. They're here to work for us. إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَضَالُّونَ, they're truly lost people, you know. They're truly lost. وَمَا أُرْسِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ حَافِظِينَ, so this statement is either Allah Azza wa Jalla saying that these kuffar, they were not sent as guardians over the believers to check up on them. Or it could be the statement of the kuffar saying that these Muslimin are not guardians over everyone else in Makkah. Why are they calling them and telling them, oh, this is, we bring this new Islam, you must believe it, otherwise, who are they? Right? So this is the other interpretation. Allah saying, فَالْيَوْمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنَ الْكُفَّارِ يَتْعَكُونَ, today the table is going to turn, right? Table is going to turn. They laughed at you that day. Today, the believers are going to laugh at the kuffar, yadhakun. عَلَى الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ, they will be reclining upon araik, cushions and sofas and pillows. يَنْظُرُونَ, just looking. Right? And then Allah Azza wa Jal says, هَلْ ثُوِّبَ الْكُفَّارُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, this is a rhetorical question. Have the disbelievers not been rewarded this day for what they should do? And today, of course, obviously, they are being compensated for what they have done. Perhaps even more than that. So that is the comprehensive and a short, brief tafsir of Surah Al-Mutaffifun, the defrauding. I hope, inshallah, you guys were able to benefit somewhat. Inshallah, we'll continue next week at the same time. If you guys have any questions or comments. Otherwise, you guys stay safe and healthy. And I'll see you guys next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.